Haha, for all you people that thought, I don't think she owns a hairbrush or shampoo or a shower. I do shower. I just don't wash my hair every day. But, you know, I did today. It needed it. So hopefully I can be a little more put together than I have been the last few days. Today's Sunday, so I figured, why not take some time, wash my hair. It's getting super long, and I need to do something with it. By the way, I love this shirt. This was meant for Thanksgiving, but guess what? Thanksgiving's over, and I'm still gonna wear it. So that is a turkey, and it says, "Thanks for giving me another reason to not give a poo." So, and then on the back it says something about 2022, or 2021, sorry. So it was from this past Thanksgiving. Anyway, I made that. It's not in my shop. I just made it for myself. Anyway, I'm going to do something with this hair because it's starting to dry. And then I have to get some paperwork to a fellow trucker so that he can renew his IFTA tags, decals, which were like on crunch time because there's literally like a day left that he can put have the old one on there. So this is what we do. Like I said in another video, I don't have a set schedule. I just do what needs to get done, whatever time and day needs to get done. So we're gonna do that, and it's like it's probably like 11:30 in the morning. And I've already been to my desk, but I have not accomplished anything that I said I would when I ended last night's video. So, like I said, I'm going to take you guys along. Whoever you guys is, I literally don't know who's watching again. But if you're watching, I'm taking you along the journey. Do a little driving, do a little view of, I don't know, I guess where all the trucks are. And show you around, and then we come back and do that screen share that I promised, because I keep for the last four videos I've been literally promising a screen share of creating things. So we're gonna finalize those thank you cards, print them on the Cricut, cut them, and while those are cutting, continue to design those keychains. And I keep saying keychains every day. I promise you there's not that many keychains. It's literally I haven't been getting to it because things keep coming up. So anyway, let's get to it. All right, I am going to go down in history as the biggest fail in vlogging history. I keep promising things, which I just need to start a vlog and just not say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, and just let it freaking happen, because I didn't get a video of me driving. I didn't get a video of the truck parking lot, so you guys can see how the trucks park down here. That's a limited space they have, and I just didn't. And now I'm back home and going to start work, basically exactly where I left off last night. I left all my screens open, I left all the stuff on my desk. And my hair is a disaster. And I just said this morning that I was gonna get my hair together. And I didn't. I mean, I did, but it's just back to what it is, frizzy. So this is what we're doing. Let me get a better angle because I keep showing you my double chin. We are going to do a screen share, because I need to. I keep promising things. Keychain, screen share, and like then I don't follow through with any of it. Truck stop. Like, it was a big bust. But I still went there. Got the paperwork to the truck driver so that they can do what they need to do tomorrow. So I'm gonna go in here to Canva and just finish whipping together these the cards that are going to go on the shirts. I actually have one example of how, excuse me, of how I have it right now, but I feel like it's a lot of work. I told you I wanted to change the cards that I have on here, so I make it super easy. This is what it is right now. I'm gonna tag it through. I don't know where everybody else tags it, but I've seen people tag it through this tag. Some people do it to the arm, or I don't know, I guess through the back of the shirt. But I don't like to do that because I feel like it's gonna start a hole and then probably unravel. So, washing instructions, thank you card. This was just a test, just to see how it looked. And it looks cute, it's fine. But again, wanna do that QR sticker. Here they are. So, gonna do something similar like this for, wait, I showed you guys this already. What's happening? I showed you in last night's, before I closed out last night's thing, what I was doing for the thank you cards. All right, so enough of that shirt. We are going to make some other stickers for DK Kane. I don't know how many she needs, but we're going to make some. 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. I am going to make 10 sheets. 10 sheets. So let's get started. So I think they turned out all right. So they're peeling off like the Kiss Cut sticker should. Just checking to make sure that they're really, you know, the Cricut's a robot, so it can make mistakes. So just making sure that it's cutting where it's supposed to be cutting, so that when I give these to her, she's not like, did a kid cut these with scissors? So I just want to make sure that the quality is decent. So that's that. That's one project out of the way. The other sheets are printing so that I can, did I say this earlier? I'm doing 10 sheets and each sheet has 4x3, so that's 12. That's 120 stickers. I think it's a good start. If she needs more, I've got the file. I can print and cut for her those last minute. We're getting somewhere. We're getting somewhere, and I'm feeling good about it. So, let's keep moving. We have 10. 10. 8 of them are going to be awesome. One is gonna be okay, and the other one probably needs to be redone. So it's fine. We'll work on it. This is a very interesting calibration test. I've never done this before on my Cricut, and this is probably why it's not cutting on the lines. So it's saying, without unloading the mat, examine the lines on the top and right of the calibration sheet. Which ones have cuts closest to the center? So the last thing that it asked me was this square here, if the lines were touching everything. And I don't know if you can see that, but where's my finger? Right here. It's below this one, and then it's like below this one. So something is going wrong in here, like it needs to shift up. So we have to see which one is closest to the center. These suck, so those are really bad. I'm thinking number 9 is perfect. So that's number 9 on that side there. And then here, I want to say I. So 9 and I. So we're going to say, which ones have the closest to the center? 9. Wait. Which ones have cuts closest to the center? Top or right? That doesn't make sense because, like, all the cuts in general, closest to the center of the paper? I am so lost. So is 9 in the center? I mean, like, 16, so 8 would be in the middle, right? I don't know what I'm doing. Like I said, taking you guys along for the ride, I'll let you know what I figure out. Okay, so I literally just had to click on the drop down. I'm losing my mind. But again, I've never done this before, so. So it was 9 on the top, I on the right, continue. And then it says to unload the mat and to reprint and retest, unload the mat and continue. So we're gonna unload the mat. We're gonna do another test print here. Let's continue. It's not the wireless, it's the regular, this printer. So we're gonna reprint it. And I need to put paper. This is a really tight squeeze here, like, it's really not 100% the best setup. Not 100% the best setup. I had that printer, and the bottom was on the second shelf, but we don't really use that, so, I wonder if the Cricut would function okay on the second shelf, and the printer on the top. I just like having the printer on, the Cricut on the top, regardless. Okay. So this is printing out, and we're gonna remove this one. Oh, well, I didn't realize it cut all the way through. So that's what this handy tool is for. If I wasn't trying to hold the phone and everything at the same time. All right, so take that off. We're gonna put this new paper on here. So make sure it's like, it doesn't have to be perfect, just 8.5 by 11. So just say meet the 8.5 here, meet the 11 here, and let's see how this works. So we've reprinted already, so now place sheet on the mat, press continue. And then it's looking for the Explorer, and we load it. I hope that this fixes the problem, and I should have done this when I first got the machine, but I didn't. And just like the tent yesterday, instructions, when I said, let me find the instructions, she said, instructions, like, was that like, wait, instructions as in it didn't come with instructions? Instructions like, do you see who we are? We don't need instructions. Or like, Who doesn't know how to put a tent together without instructions? I don't know. I never put a tent together. And it was very easy. But this girl is experienced in tents, I guess, because she just had a wedding. So, about a year ago. And she's used to it. She probably put up like 100 tents that day. So, anyway, we're going to let this cut. It's cutting now. All right, so that looks pretty dang good. Let's see if we can actually tear out this square. Maybe not. I want to see if it actually cut in the middle. Did it even cut good? Looks pretty close to me. I think we calibrated it. So, continue. I don't know why it's wanting to do it again, but it looks fine. It looks calibrated. Like, I don't know what else it's... Calibrating machine improves, so whatever. Are you sure you want to cancel? Well, I want to go back. So, I just finished all those stickers for the DK Canes QR code. It shouldn't have taken that long. I had to keep feeding stuff back into the Cricut to cut because it wasn't cutting all the way around. I calibrated my machine 3 times and I didn't realize after the 3rd time it was gonna tell me that I need to contact support, Cricut support, because I can't try to calibrate it myself more than three times. I've never heard of such a thing, but those are the rules and I'm not doing that again. I'm not messing around with it. So I moved on. That's for the print then cut. When you're just cutting vinyl, it doesn't matter because you're not trying to cut around a particular design that was printed. All you're doing is taking like a blank sheet of vinyl like this. Isn't that great? A blank sheet of vinyl like this and simply cutting a design into it. So that's what we're gonna do for these. I've already peeled all the stickers that were like on the bottom that had the brand name and got that out of the way. So I'm gonna go ahead and do some stickers like some of the designs I already have, because I want to use them. I don't see why not. Maybe some of the designs that are on the koozies for people who don't want koozies but they want a cup, I guess. And like simple ones. When I sip, you sip, we sip. Like, why would that not work on a cup? That works on a cup. So these are already loaded into Cricut. I have to do like a layout, I guess, or change the size of them. Now, this is an issue. So I have 2 different style cups. I have these, I'm calling them, what were they called? Square cups, I think. Square tumblers. They're square because they're still round, but they have like a flat edge here, a flat edge here. I mean, basically flat. Whereas this one is round. And they're both tapered. This one's tapered a little bit more. So when you're doing the design, it's really, you have to be really careful when you're doing that. Because if the design is a wider design that's wrapping around, you have to be mindful of that. So either use a template that will work for that. I don't usually make tumblers. I don't make tumblers. I've seen tons of like Instagram reels and stuff where people are making them, and I don't know if it's my thing yet. So I'm just making these for fun, and well, to sell, but for fun for this event. But it's not something that I don't think I would keep this right now in my shop. It's just something to sell at this event. So I think what I'm gonna do is I might put a design like on one side here and then another side. I don't think on the square ones I'm gonna do it all the way around. Or I can do like, say I'm doing like a pineapple, flamingo, palm tree and a beach ball or something. I don't know. One on each side. That might work too. Because this actually has sides, whereas this one is just, there is no, it's just one thing. There's no size. So I don't even know what I'm doing yet. I just have, I know I want to start working with this vinyl and we're going to make it work. So let's go. All right. So I decided to go with a simple summer breeze and palm trees design. So I'm weeding this out. I've done a couple already. Oops, making a mess here. So this one already has one side on it. So this is what the other one looks like. Just a simple palm tree on one side and this on the other side. Summer breeze and palm trees, and it's backwards. Let me turn this on so you can read it. Summer breeze and palm trees, but that vinyl, I really like it. And this is just the silver one. I feel like the purple one is going to be really nice. There's this. I think I should have done this circle bigger, but I didn't want it to be so overpowering. I don't know. I'm going to leave it, I think. I might do something around, like, on the sides here. It just looks super plain. So I might do some, like, little stars or, who knows, waves, something. I'll think of something. And it's really nice on the blue, too. So I just hope that this stays on. It is permanent vinyl, but you never know. You gotta let it sit. You're not supposed to wash it for like a day, 24 hours, I think is what they said. So you're not supposed to wash it until it's been sitting for a while, which obviously, I mean, we've got like 10 days until somebody's gonna probably use it or more. But yeah, I'm gonna do a few of each design. I don't have that many tumblers considering how many people will be there, but who goes to somewhere and like, oh god, I came here to buy cups. So I just have to think, like, how many people are actually gonna buy cups? I have a feeling they're gonna sell out, but are they gonna be flying in back on Sunday like, I'm back here to buy the rest of your cups? Probably not. So I have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have 12 of the square, wait, now I have 12 of the square. 12 of the square ones, and I have not that many of the other ones. So this is this. So there's 9. That's a lie too. That's 12 of these. So there's 16 of the square, and there's 12 of these. So I think we're going to be okay. I'm glad I didn't get more, because then I'd be sitting here trying to figure out what am I going to put on these. I just bought these on a whim. And I thought they were really cute. I love plastic tumblers. If you have kids, not even kids, more like me. I've dropped stuff before, like glasses and stuff. So I just prefer plastic cups. I don't know. I don't know what it is. But they're light. They're one less thing to worry about when you drop it. And they last forever. So yeah, I'm gonna keep weeding this vinyl, and whenever I do some more designs, I will film that as well. Okay, so it's almost 11 o'clock at night. I did not show you what else I did. Because I did stuff, but I didn't do much stuff after. I didn't do any more new designs. They're on the screen, and I also wrote down ideas for other ones that I want to do tomorrow. But I am going to stop promising when I start the vlogs in the morning what I'm going to do. I mean, I'm going to give you an idea again. Hey, you, I don't know who you are. What's going on? It's probably just going to be me rewatching this because I have 0 followers, but that's fine. That's what happens when you start a channel, I guess. You start with 0. So anyway, I'm going to stop promising myself and whoever may be potentially editing or even watching the video, what I have planned for the day, or what I'm gonna accomplish A, B, C, D, you know, like, no. This is my to-do list. This is what I'm going to work on or attempt to work on. We'll just see how the day plays out, because I have to give myself some grace. Like, I never go to bed this early. I went to bed so late last night, like 3, well, more like in the morning, like 3 a.m. and then woke up pretty early. I mean, like before 9, I think. Anyway, and I'm super tired now. I have a headache. I've been staring at the screen all day. I just couldn't do it. So I said, I'm going to eat dinner and I'm going to lay down. So that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to stop promising every morning. Ah, I'm going to get up and I'm going to like do all these things. I'm going to get like every single thing done. Because when I do it and then I say, and I'm going to record this and I'm going to screen share. And I'm like, yes, I shared my screen today a bit. I didn't share any designing because I had, like, the designs were basically done and I tweaked those cards. And I had a really, that's why I have a headache. Now I remember. I was doing the cards that I said I was going to do. The washing, the thank you, rewind, the shirt tags that I put on the shirts, I almost had it. Like, I had it, and they were so lined up and so ready. So I said, okay, I'm not doing it through the Cricut. I'm going to see if I can get as many on one page as I can, which I think I got like 8 or actually it might have been 10. 10. So it would have been 10 thank you, and then if you flip it over, it's going to have the washing instructions. Unfortunately, for whatever reason, I literally lined up everything in Canva. It's when you do that double-sided thing. And I don't know if, like, it's because a printer is a printer. And when you just rest the paper in the feeder in the back, it might be a little bit off. Like, whatever it is, when you flip it over it and put in exactly how it's telling you to put it in, it's perfect. You have the design on one side, you flip it over, the design looks like it would be the exact, and if you cut it, it should be exactly, like, everything should fit. No. It's like a few centimeters off. Or centimeters, probably, yeah. I don't know my metric system, but anyway, it's just a tad bit off, and you can't, if I was to just cut it and then flip it over, the back's gonna be messed up. So I'll have to show you tomorrow what I mean. And it's just super annoying. Like, if you hold it up to a light, those rectangles for the tags should line up, and they don't. So that's a problem. I'm going to try it one more time tomorrow. And if I can't get it, I am in crunch time, and I might just send them off to print somewhere. I might be able to get away with a business card size. Because I took my business card and I lined it up to the card that I designed, and it's not that far off. So I might be able to just tweak it and send it to Canva, like Canva prints business cards. That's where I got my business cards. I might be able to do that. However, they're not super fast with shipping, and I wanted to do it here. Like, I invested so much money in this Cricut and buying the cardstock. Like, that's the whole point. So I'm just rambling on, but I really want to be able to look back at this and be like, what? Like, your event was so successful, but like, look at all the crap you had to go through. Like, that's not that I want to go through the crap, but I'm going through it. And I want to be able to say, do you see, like, if you watch all these vlogs, like, that's what it takes to go through. And it's so crazy. Like, I woke up this morning and I had such good energy, and like, I am gonna do all this stuff. And then when I started doing the DK Kane's QR stickers, I'm glad that I did them, because she deserves to have them, and I wanted to do that for her. But when I realized that the Cricut had like calibrating, like I just don't understand. I don't understand. It's a brand new machine. I was trying to set it up like properly, It was, I followed the instructions and it just, then when they told me, oh, you can't calibrate it more than 3 times, I'm like, but it's still not perfect. We have to reach out to support. Like, I don't have time for that. So I had to stop the QR sticker project and move on to the next one. But stopping to calibrate alone took away probably an hour of my time, if not more. I don't even know how long I was sitting there. That and the fact that before I actually calibrated, I calibrated because I got frustrated with having to recut over and over. And then even though it was having, I was recutting it because it wasn't cutting all the way, like as much, you know, it wasn't creating the kiss cut deal. It was like, it would cut one side and then the rest of the circle wouldn't be cut at all. So I'm like, okay, the blade is clean. Like the blade's sharp. I tested it. I don't know what's going on. So that ate up a lot of my, you know, like between 1 p.m. and probably like 3 p.m. It just took way longer than it had to. I knew what it had to get done. I had all the DK Canes things printed out and it was just the cutting issue. So if that's the issue, like, I don't know. It's a learning process. So I'm sitting here talking to myself and we're 7 minutes like into a video and I just wanted to get on and say, I'm tired. I have a headache. I put in a lot of work today, but when I look at it, I'm like, what actually got done? Like what got done? I was doing a bunch of work, but what do I have to show for that? Like 4 tumblers and they're not even done. Like the tumbler still needs, like I'm still adding stuff to it. And there's still, like I said, 16 tumblers in the round ones, the regular ones. And then the square tumblers, there's 12, I think is what I don't remember. That's a lot to get through. And that's like additional on top of the other things that I have to do. I still didn't press the stupid hats that I said. Desiree gave me the assignment, press the hats. Like that's what you're going to do tomorrow. That was today. It's not done. So anyway, tomorrow is a new day. Like I said yesterday, last night, tomorrow's going to be a new day. Every day is a new day. But like, if you keep doing nothing or doing stuff and really not getting stuff done, you're never going to finish. So it's panic time right now. And I can just feel my body like going into like burnout mode. And I can't. Tomorrow's Monday. I'm going to have to do stuff for ConvertKit as well. And I need to balance it. Like my son will be in school, so I'll be able to, you know, I won't have any like distractions or anything, but I need to go to bed now. I said that at 9 o'clock and I'm still awake at almost 11. So I deserve to go to bed. It's Sunday, like take a break, go to bed early, and I will wake up fresh and ready to, conquer the week. Conquer the freaking week. We have this week, and then I have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday of the following week, and that's it. That is it. So, yeah, super crunch time, and tomorrow's the 20th of February. And then Tuesday is the 1st of March. So we are cramming in this work this week. Cramming it in. Like 36 hours a day is what I'm going to be working. If that's even possible. So anyway, I'm going to shut up now. I'm tired. And see you in the morning. Bright and early.